Today we're going to be talking a little bit about concealed carry and some techniques for reloading your semi-automatic pistol that you need to be aware of. Joining us on Shoot of the Series, I'm Ed Thorell from Firearms Education and Training. We'd like to start off by thanking all of our YouTube followers for giving us good traction and sticking with us. If you haven't already, hit the little bell so you can get instant notifications, but also like us and share us. For our, those that want to help support us, check us out on Patreon. Now, today, we're going to talk a little bit about some techniques for reloading your semi-auto pistol in the realm of concealed carry. And these are all little tools that you keep in your bag of tricks for when you might need them. Now, it's also real important with any of these drills that you spend some time practicing with them, because these all have a shelf life. This is a lot like playing a musical instrument. You're not going to be a rock star if you don't practice. Now, what we're going to talk about today is the difference between what's known as combat reloads and administrative reloads, and they're very different. What most people are aware of is the combat reload, to where you fire your gun until it's empty, the slide locks back, you drop the magazine, you put a fresh one in it, you let the slide go home, and you're back to business. Okay, that's the most conventional way of doing things. There's also the administrative reload, which is just as important, if not more important. What the administrative reload allows you to do is, if you've once you've engaged, fired a couple of rounds, you're able to eject the partially fill but not empty magazine and top it off with a brand new fresh one with a round in the chamber, meaning you get back into the firefight and suddenly you've topped off. And the analogy that I like to use is this. If you were driving to Vegas on a long trip, you'd be crazy not to stop to Barstow and fill up your tank again. So the reason for the administrative reload is so that your gun, just like your gas tank, never goes dry. It's important that you learn how to train with both of these, because it's a technique that could save your life. Stick around, we're gonna show you how all of this works.
Thanks for watching our videos. And if you enjoy watching them and wanna see more of them, you can also consider come checking us out on our Patreon channel. For as little as $2 a month, you'll have access to the blogs, you'll have access to extra original videos, discounts on clothing, and also some giveaways. So come check us out.
All right, we're back. We're going to go through a drill showing the difference between an administrative reload and a combat reload. Got a live magazine in one hand. Going to pull my pistol and get it charged up and ready to go. Just like we've shown in other drills, get used to loading your pistol by putting your finger on the top round. In the middle of the night, when it's dark, this will prevent you from ever loading it backwards and jamming up your gun. So get in the habit. Slide it in. Give it a good tap, rack, finger off the trigger always. And whenever you reholster, look at what you're doing. Reholstering is purely an administrative act. You want to make sure that you avoid accidents by always reholstering and looking when you're doing it. Don't just assume you're going to find it. Most accidents happen at the holster. That's where you have to be the most careful. All right. So the scenario is this. There's a bad guy. There's a threat. I have to clear my garment. I pull a loaded pistol. I go on target. Gun goes dry. A combat reload is to take the empty gun, fresh magazine, load it up, ready to go. However, you don't want to stay in one place. In this time, during the scenario, I found cover or concealment. Concealment will not stop a bullet. Cover will. This isn't stopping anything. So, from cover, I'm going to peek, going to find the adversary. and I'm going to take a break. I know my next time out, I'm going to come around the corner fully committed, topped off. Now you'll notice the slide did not lock back. I've got a round in the chamber and I've got a partial magazine that I can use in reserve later on. I'm going to take a fresh magazine, completely topped off, fill it up in the same way as if you were driving to Vegas, you would fill up in Barstow. This way the gun never goes dry. So when I re-engage the target, I can come around cover, fully commit, knowing that I've got a full magazine. We're empty, we're safe, we're clear. So this is one more training tip to have in your bag of tricks. But just like everything else, you have to train and practice. Just because you hand me a guitar does not mean I'm a rock star. So what you need to do is actively train, not until you get it right, but until you can't get it wrong. So we've just gone over between an administrative reload and a combat reload. Once again, this is empty. I'm gonna look at my holster. All right, thanks again for joining us through this drill. Once again, I'd like to thank all of our YouTube subscribers. Also, you can check us out on Patreon. I'm Ed Thorell from Firearms Education and Training, and for Shooters of the Series, thanks for stopping by. Y'all take care.